The green birds used metal blades to cut the air and lift flesh, bone, and blood, a generation of men, into the sky. Above and over the patchwork fields, thousands of feet high, into the valley, into ambush, injury, and death. Easter service concluded. Chaplain Brown enters the Huey. M79 hits Chipley's bird. Dolphin 21 down. Fights on. Satchel charges thrown in. 5 explosions. Small arms fire. The day before, Delta Company, the 120th Infantry, 11th Light Infantry Brigade, 23rd Infantry, Americal Division, comes into the Saint-Vie Valley, flown in from Landing Zone Dragon. The thud of the blades slicing through the thick, humid heat, machine gun mounted in the doorway. Landing zone, colors of smoke mark the spot. Huey dips in and halts. His legs sway over the skids like seabed tendrils in a rough sea. Delta Company is to work its way up from the lowlands to relieve Alpha Company, 3rd Platoon. Far away in distance and time, how one begins to measure loss. And tears cried, years passed, displaying human traits for those left behind in time. The place, the heavenly realm then, where we may meet those we love. Once again, to cherish them forevermore. The place? Saint-Vie Valley, near the Saint-Vie River, northwest of Ducteau. The time? April 11th, 1971. Names written into mirrored gabbro's walls where we see ourselves in Washington, D.C. I look into the eyes of Edward Percy Pilkington of Clayton, North Carolina. The youth of ages past, present and future, I see myself staring back. The dead, unknowing of the human emotional cost of war, only the living bear it in grief. Where he and other men were, died, or were injured that April day in 1971. My father, William Irwin Hinton, months later to the north at Fubai. The wall could have easily bore his name. Hallowed ground for missing hearts back home. Those hills near the Saint-Vie Valley, where American blood was spilled. For right, for wrong, for politics, for freedom. The reasons not certain to history. But the ultimate sacrifice moving the human heart to ache. These men served, lived, and died in principle for the United States and its people. I cannot be with these men and their families, yet I yearn for us all to be one. But I find a godly love transcending time, reaching out to them here in words. I beg God to whisper my respect into their eternal ears. Firebase Bronco, to Landing Zone Liz and beyond. From Quang Nai and the Saint-Vie Valley in Vietnam, to the East Tennessee Valley. Onward to Knoxville and Clayton, North Carolina, and beyond. America has a hole in her heart, born into American hearts. Those who served in her wars, be they injured, alive, or dead. The very best of men, found here in American souls. In wars on foreign soils, American men will always die, so that their country might remain. I will love them all the same. Hold their forever beautiful, pure faces, unblemished by time, in my hands, and weep their cheeks red. Before their deaths or injuries, they would have only asked me why. I would do such a thing. Where loving spirit lives on, walking along green grass, among neatly arranged headstones bearing your names, hand brushed along etchings into hard surfaces. People who never knew you, but love you in sincere admiration for your sacrifice. Those who ponder the past and our place in the world today. Along with those who were there with you, ponder with searing eyes red from saddened strain, and wonder at the fragility of life. In wars, Americans will always die, so that their country might remain. The flag I raise in the bright blue sky, kissed by the sun, shining through fabric, red, white, and blue, means that freedom has not perished from this earth. I beg we find the way where love is love when war ends. Caught ever so faintly off the South China Sea, or in the winds from wherever American blood paid for freedom, you can almost hear it if you listen closely. There is a whisper. It moves men's hearts, moves men's eyes to tears. This feeling. Almighty God, I swear I cannot help it or hold it back. Coming from deep in the jungles of Vietnam, there is a whisper. In these men's last words on earth, to heal, to love, to never forget. They are my brothers I never knew. I love them all.